YouTube, what's going on? Welcome back to the channel. As you can see from the title of the video, today I'm going to be checking out Spiritbox. This is the wrong video. I just realized it's not Blessed Be. It is their new video, which is called Constance. Now, backstory as to how I got into Spiritbox is obviously their Holy Roller video blew up. It really kind of set them off. But I feel like when I go back and watch my reaction to Holy Roller, and I've really kind of grown to love that track. It's so goddamn intense. I feel like my first reaction was somewhat, I won't say understated, because that's just how I reacted at the time, but it just never clicked with me whilst watching that video. I never mentioned it because I just didn't know. It was my first time hearing them, that the lead singer is a female. Like, I was just of the opinion and assumed that it was male. Obviously, throughout the video for Holy Roller, there is the lead singer, you know, shown throughout, but I thought she was just a, you know, a part of the video or a part of the band, or like just an actor for the video. And then the lead singer was a male, and he was just, you know, had his vocals overlaid over the video of her. But then I realized, after watching other people's reactions and seeing them Spiritbox on Instagram, I realized, oh shit. So I've since gone on to realize that Courtney LaPlante, or LaPlante, I don't know exactly how to say it, is the lead singer or lead vocalist of Spiritbox. So that just adds a whole new dynamic to it, because it's now got that like ginger effect where it's like really unassuming. You look at her, she's a real pretty girl, and then you're just like, what the fuck? So today we're going to be checking out their brand new track. It's called Constance. There's an official music video for it as well, so I don't really know what to expect. I've seen like titles from other reactions, and I think this might be a little bit different to what they've done before. Now again, I've only heard Holy Roller, and then I think I may have heard one of their other tracks. But I couldn't even name it, to be honest. I don't know which one it was. So I know obviously Spiritbox have got a reputation for just being fucking ridiculously heavy, but maybe we'll get something different, guys. So if you haven't already, please drop a like in this video. I'll be much appreciated. Subscribe to the channel if you're new. So yeah, without any further ado, we're gonna jump in, guys. Drop a like in this video if you haven't already. Subscribe to the channel if you are new. We are less than 2,000 subscribers away, less than 1,800 subscribers away from 100,000 subscribers, guys. So the goal is before the end of the year. That gives us like 25 days. It will salvage 2020 as being the worst year of all time. But anyway, guys, let's jump into the video. Let's go. Ah, fuck, this is gonna be sad already. I know it. Anything to do with old people just gets me, man. Fuck. If my son won't say tonight, I look around, but it's so hard for me. Like a shadow passing by, crashing into ships and then fading with my innocence. Give it up, complacent, just enough to escape it. Heretics wouldn't face. I don't want it.
Breakdown snuck in there. That's Spiritbox that I know. Range of vocals she has as well. That's like the cutest old lady I've ever seen. Constance. Yeah, crazy range. Absolutely crazy range she has. Obviously, I think the main thing that sticks out from that is the versatility of Spiritbox, especially the lead vocalist. Obviously, the instrumentals were a little bit slower, but they still went back to that dirty, fucking clunky, sludgy riffs that they had in Holy Roller. But for anyone who hasn't heard Holy Roller, this is the kind of versatility.
Simon and Joe.
Same band. Same band. See what I mean though, boy? Like I just thought that Courtney in this video was just a part of, you know, the video production, nothing to do with the actual band. I thought she was just like miming the lyrics, but obviously I know now, and it just adds that extra shock value to it, that extra cool element to the band. But obviously very, very talented, like I said, really, really versatile. I believe the concept of that video, from what I interpreted anyway, is to do with Alzheimer's, which I haven't been affected by personally. Well, obviously not personally, but you know what I mean, anyone in my immediate family. But obviously I know how kind of gut-wrenching that can be for someone. I've known people that have known people that have dealt with that, and I can't really, you know, empathize, because like I said, I haven't, but I can just only imagine how hard it can be to kind of go through that. And that seems to be what the video is depicting. I didn't really pay too much attention to the lyrics. I was just trying to kind of feel the song and the rhythm of it and the melody. But the main takeaway for me is, like I keep going back to, the versatility of this band. Having only heard Holy Roller and then going to this, you'd just think they're two completely separate bands from a vocal perspective, but they do stay true to what a lot of people love them for, and that's that sludgy metal, like those dirty guitar riffs. And then you had the little Gojira slide that they've threw in quite a bit in Holy Roller as well, which I really loved. So yeah, I see one of the comments on the video as well: Holy Roller slaps me physically, Constance slaps me emotionally. Facts. But yeah guys, I really enjoyed that track. I'll have to listen to it a few more times to really kind of delve into it and see what my final thoughts are on it. But let me know in the comment section what you guys thought of it. Make sure to drop a like in this video if you haven't already. If there's any other Spiritbox tracks that you do want me to check out, then do let me know in the comment section down below, guys. As always, thank you so much for watching. I'm signing out. Take care of yourselves. Cheers.